here's our eight exercises. We're gonna start with a single leg side lunge up to a single arm pull up. Okay, so across the body, seat back, drive up, and then weight under chin. We'll alternate sides. And then we've got both dumbbells for reverse lunge with curl. We're gonna alternate sides and bicep curls. Then we've got, we're gonna come down on the mat. We'll be kneeling for extended arm kickbacks. That's exercise three. Exercise four is hip raises on the mat, so driving through our heels, pressing our hips to the ceiling. Then we've got push-up variations, skull crushers, side planks, and we're gonna finish up on our feet with front and lateral shoulder raises with both dumbbells, all right? So starting with just a single dumbbell for side lunge with a single arm pull-up. We'll get the countdown going and we will get started. If you're keeping track of your November scorecard, we're doing the core work today in class. Break, switch sides. Break. Break. All right, one more each side. Go. Break. Last one. Go. Great, good work. Set that weight outside, step your feet wide. Start with a forward fold to the center. Walk your hands to the left. Hands to the right. Place Place your left hand on the floor, right tip, fingertips to the ceiling. Lunge to the right. Swap your hands out, right hand to the floor, left fingertips to the ceiling. Lunge to the left. Come around to a down dog. Pedal your feet. Okay. Go to your bed. I'm getting a lot of help. Forward fold, you've got about 20 seconds left, so whatever feels good here. Then we're going to go into reverse lunge with curls. All right, grab your bicep curl weights. We're going to alternate lunge with the bicep curl. Go. Break. Go to your bed. Round two. Go. She kind of blends into the floor. Go. I asked for prayer on Tuesday because Ian was going in yesterday morning, but he did great. A little scared with anesthesia, but that was his 10th surgery, so he's quite familiar. Break. Halfway there. He's quite familiar with what has to happen, but older it gets, the scarier it is, so go. But the doctor was happy with the results and said he shouldn't be in too much pain, so. And it was surgery to his outside of his knees, I think it was the fibula growth plate that they were breaking or drilling into, that they were drilling into to stop the growth of that bone. Go. Because his legs are growing twisted and in a way that is not safe or would be long-term bad. So he'll still grow, but that bone will not. So that will help the legs straighten. Break. Last one coming up. So it sounded painful enough to me, but they assured us it's not that painful. Go. All right, so when we go to the mat, you're gonna want at least one medium weight with you, medium to heavy, hip raisers and skull crushers. And then you might bring a lighter weight for the extended arm kickbacks. All right, so I'm gonna have a couple options. Now we've got butterflies and froggers. So starting with butterflies, Daisy's gonna love this. Okay, feet together, knees apart. She's under my back. squatters. All right, so these ones, knees sit, draw your knees into your chest. Or V sit, I'm sorry, I think I said V sit, to be fair. I've got a little extra going on this morning. Out and in. More than halfway there. Good work. Five. Great. Good work. All right, come around. You're kneeling. We're going to hinge forward for extended arm kickbacks. Grab those dumbbells. Go. Get a squeeze up top. Break. Make sure you're controlling your down motion as well. We're still squeezing our glutes in this position. Go. Break. Round three. Go. Break. Good work. Go. Break. Good work. Two more. Go. Great. Good work. Last one. Go. We'll come into a cat and cow stretch after this. Break. All right, set those aside. Go ahead, reach your fingertips out in front of you. Press your seat to the back. Ooh. Let your forehead drop to the mat. Roll from temple to temple. Walk your fingertips over to the left for a deep side stretch. Walk your fingertips to the right. thread your right fingertips under your left armpit. Bring that shoulder across your body. Press into a deep shoulder stretch. Walk your left fingertips under your right armpit. Deep shoulder stretch. I'll get Tuesday's recording up by the weekend. If you missed it, definitely make it up. It was a good one. We worked hard. And sweat. Good work, roll over to your back. It's time for hip raises, so grab that heavier weight for your hip bones. You're going to drive up through your heels and onto your shoulder blades. Bring those hips to the ceiling. Break. Good work. Here we go again. Go. Break. Go. Break. Whew. Good work. Halfway. Three more. Go. Break. Two more. Go. Good job. One more. I didn't know my glutes were sore. Go. I didn't know my glutes were sore or tired until we did these. Break. Good work. Set that weight aside. Toe taps. Stack your feet up above your hips. Reach up to the air. Reach up to tap your toes. See, buddy. She's just waiting for somebody to open this door. Good work. 20 seconds. heel taps. Good work. See this through. We're almost there. 5 seconds. We're going to flip over for push-ups. Break. All right. Flip over. We're going to start with the traditional military push-up. Knees or toes. Uh-oh. Go. The dog is not going to cooperate. Break. You're going to bring your hands into just below your chest in a diamond. Put your pointer finger and your thumbs together. Elbows go out to the side. Go. If you are on your toes, more power to you. Break. Good work. Let's take our seats up in the air. Pike push-ups. All right, seats in the air. Forehead's coming down to the mat. Tricep push-ups, and you'll get to pick your favorite. Go. Break. Last round, pick your favorite push-up style. Go. Open up your left knee. I don't know if you missed push-up variations, but we're onto stretching our left IT now, so bring that left knee across your chest. knee collapse around, shoulder blades to the mat. Oh, that's the deep twist I needed all week. All right, if you can, keep that leg straight up and then open it up to the left 90 degree angle, keeping that right bum cheek to the mat. This is the kind where I could use the assistance with a loop band or something. Left, if you want to make an adjustment or cross that foot over your right knee, press that left knee open. Good, Jenny. Break. All right, we're going into skull crushers next. Morning, Jenny, whenever you're warm. We're on our back. Bent knees for skull crushers. Press your spine into the mat. Break. So these always have that core element to them, that you're pressing your spine into the mat. Go. And not letting it curve off the floor. Break. Round three. Go. Break. Halfway there. Go. Break. Two more. Break. Good, last one coming up. Go. Break. Good work. All right, set that aside. Back to our butterflies and froggers. So let's start with froggers this time. You're in a V hold, drawing those knees into your chest. Tap your heels. So Jenny, if you didn't see the scorecard yet, November's scorecard is all about core. So this is on today. So since you showed up, you'll get in what you need to. Mm. job. Now we're going right into butterflies. All right, butterfly those knees out, feet together. If you have a dog in your way, just do your best. Quite the week here. So Ian had surgery yesterday, recovering well. Charlie got the flu, so we're over to side planks next. Ooh. All right, press up and hold. Charlie woke up with the flu. Well, I think he was sick Monday. They had a state playoff game round one for soccer on Monday night. He played that game and went out to grab something to eat, came home and immediately went to bed, well, showered and went to bed. Break. Then he woke up Tuesday with a 102 temp. Flip other side. Thankfully, nobody else has shown any signs or symptoms. My parents are also visiting. They came last weekend. So that's been fun, but, you know, added activity. But thankfully, they've stayed well. Chip and I have stayed well. Ian stayed well. And we think maybe Jack had this flu last week. But I was away, and I don't think Chip took his temp. So he has to cough a bit, but go. But Ian, I don't know if I told you guys, Ian's school closed Wednesday to Friday this week because so many people are sick with the flu. So he wasn't going to be able to go anyway because surgery, so it's well timed. Flip. And then to top it all off, I'm on a flight tomorrow, very early morning, through Dallas to go to Monterrey, Mexico for a work event, but there's supposed to be bad weather in Dallas tomorrow, so I'm not sure what I'm doing there. You are a pain to work out with. Break. One more each side. Go. Your right knee to your chest this time. But not surprisingly, waking up this morning, I was like, oh my gosh, how is it Thursday already? So there you go, with a week like that. Does fly by. Open that right knee up. Maybe not if you're a teacher in school with kids who have been hyped up on Halloween candy all week, would be my guess.
So sorry about that to both of you. But you're amazing. I don't know how you do it. Bring your left knee across your body. Good, straighten that leg out above your hip, then open up to the right in a 90 degree angle, keeping your left bone cheek to the mat. This, of course, is only assuming that you don't have a dog in your way. My dog would prefer I did not do this right now. There's a bed right there for you. Good work, 10 seconds here. We're gonna finish on our feet with light weights for front and side shoulder raises. Okay, on our feet, front and lateral shoulder raises, grab those weights, go. Break. Good work. Go. Break. Good work. Round three. Go. Charlie's temp was down all day yesterday, though. He woke up with it spiked a little bit, break, only at, I mean, like 101 something, and then it was down after he took Tylenol at 8, and then it stayed down, go, stayed down the rest of the day, and no more medicine given, so I hope that means we're through it. We'll see how he is this morning. Break, two more. Go. And break, one more. All right, after this, Karen, you'll stretch. Go. Jenny and I are gonna hit one more round of Froggers and Butterflies so we can check it off our scorecard. Break. All right, good work. Karen, good job. Have a great day.